breakthrough, then above all, eternity, which everybody is seeking for.
In a country of over 150 million people, 80% live on less than $2 a day. The aspiration for many is to achieve the Nigerian dream, to have and be seen to have cars, houses, money and power. Many of the new independent churches promise that if you follow them, your dreams will come true.
There are now over 70 million Christians living in Nigeria, and that number's growing faster here than anywhere else in the world. On the four roads around here, I've counted over 20 churches. There seems to be one every two or three blocks. There's another one just over there, the New Anointing Deliverance Ministries International. Just a huge number of churches in a very small space.
Dr. Fireman's image seemed to tap into this idea of the Nigerian dream, of displaying your wealth openly. At his home in central Lagos, he showed me his three luxury cars worth over £150,000.
Why yellow?
When I was small, I always loved yellow. When I was small, my mom bought me a yellow plate, a yellow spoon, and a yellow t-shirt. Everything had to be yellow. And so till now, I think I'm a yellow freak.
Fireman was due to preach at one of his branches that evening, so he went upstairs to change. Style is a key element of his marketing.
It's like if you have something that is very good, but the container is bad. Though the content is good, it's difficult to sell.
We left for the service with a security escort. Fireman said he'd been mobbed in the past. He claimed it was because he was known to give cash to the poor.
There have been times they climbed the vehicle on every side and surrounded the car, you can't move.
The service was being held in a middle-class neighborhood called Festac on the outskirts of the city. Tonight's service was called a crusade. It's a special promotional event where Dr. Fireman appears at a local branch to help win new converts.
Whatever you came here looking for, you'll find.
The sermon was all about how to get rich through God. This is known as prosperity preaching.
I've discovered the secret in God for the higher life. Get what I'm saying? But many of us are still living at the lower life.
He teaches prosperity as a sign of spiritual blessing, and the key to becoming rich is to give money to the church. He calls this sowing the seed, but it doesn't end there.
You can't sow your seed just anywhere. A wrong ground produces the wrong harvest.
For this to work, it seemed important to give to the right person. The pastor in charge of this branch gave testimony of how Fireman has changed his life.
I was very poor and wretched. I wasn't even a pastor. And he saw me from the gutter and picked me up. In 5 months, I got 3 cars. It happened like magic. I started getting money like that. I wasn't dressed like this before. Those that know me some years ago will know. And I don't wear gold wristwatch. And I don't wear designer style.
Thank you, Jesus.
Once again, the message was donating money would be a shortcut to achieving your material dreams.
I want to see people riding a Lamborghini. I want to see somebody walk out of this place today and you buy your Bentley.
I've spent a long day with Dr. Fireman and I really feel like I'm starting to understand him. He sells himself brilliantly, he markets himself brilliantly, he's incredibly charismatic, and even though his performance seems just as crude and manipulative to me as it did on Sunday, he's upstairs and he's winning over a whole new congregation.
Local journalist Simon Ateba has spent the last 5 years covering the rise of these new churches. He said that while some were genuine, well-run operations, it was almost impossible to establish their true wealth.
Oh, Chris Oyakhilo, man, he's the business pastor. He has churches in South Africa, churches in the US, in Houston in the US, churches in England, churches in other African countries. He has businesses, he has printing press, he has television station, has newspaper, has magazine. Yeah, that's the church. Yeah.
Simon took us to the headquarters of the pastor's church, Christ Embassy. 2 years ago, he tried to get some photographs of the building.
I was with a photojournalist, and we were about taking a picture of this church from this side of the road. They dragged us inside and beat me until I fainted. I was arriving in the hospital.
Why do they want to attack journalists like that?
You know, only the pastor knows how much money they are getting. So they are trying to hide all those things, trying to hide how much money they are making.
We wanted to speak to Christ Embassy, but a security guard stopped us from filming.
There's security, okay.
Then I was dragged inside the church.
Probably about 10 security guards came over and dragged me by the belt into their building. It was almost exactly the situation that Simon Ateba described to me this morning. But luckily, I didn't end up getting beaten up.
Christ Embassy later told us they were too busy to be interviewed. We contacted all the wealthiest churches, but only one would speak to us. It's called the Household of God.
This whole street is called Household of God Street because it's owned by the church.
It's run by Reverend Chris Okotie, a former pop star who had hits in the 80s with records such as Secret Love and Show Me Your Backside.
Morning, Pastor.
Morning.
In 1984, he found God, set up his own church, and is now reported to be worth £6 million. His 5,000-member congregation come from the wealthier elements of Nigerian society, film stars, celebrities, and musicians. There are security guards everywhere.
It seems that most of the people here have come to see him using his talents, and he does so brilliantly. The majority of this service is him singing and dancing on stage, and of course, talking in tongues.
The congregation may have been wealthier than Dr. Fireman's, but the message was the same.
If you follow the laws of giving and of sowing and reaping, then you begin to prosper materially.
Through prosperity preaching and the success of his church, he built a power base that enabled him to contest the last three presidential elections.
Nigeria is a rich nation. It's just that the leaders would not give what the people desire to them because they're corrupt leaders.
Nigeria has, over the years, been failed by its leaders. They've made themselves wealthy. You see them driving around with huge convoys. But when I look at the religious leaders, with all due respect, yourself included, I don't see anything different.
The difference is that we practice a philosophy that guarantees prosperity. God has offered an alternative, a church where there's equality, there is prosperity, there is hope, there is faith. Choose.
Okotie's success was an example of the potential path ahead for Dr. Fireman. Before leaving Nigeria, I wanted to speak to him again. He was in the music studio, recording a track, an expansion of the Perfect Christianity ministry into the music business.
Why did God choose you?
You want to die.
I don't.
At the recording session, I asked him about what I'd seen during my time with him.
People believe in miracles, and it's quite easy to use their belief to make yourself rich, and that's what I see you doing.
Was Jesus poor?
Jesus was a poor man, yes.
He was not.
Jesus had nothing.
No, it's a lie. You don't know the Bible.
Jesus had nothing.
It's not true.
His followers had things which they gave
to him.
Jesus had nothing of his
own. It's not true. I have the Bible here. We can open it and go through if there is time. Jesus was rich and had an accountant that followed him in the name of Judas Iscariot.
Jesus was poor and humble, being the key point there. He was humble.
Let me ask a question.
If Jesus lived now, he wouldn't drive a bright yellow Hummer.
If I'm humble, God will bless me. You say Jesus touched people, the sick. You watch me in church, I laid hands on the sick.
I should say, for the sake of honesty, that what I saw in the church, I didn't believe for a second.
That's the reason why it's divine healing.
90% of the pastors in the world wouldn't believe you.
It's not true.
The ones who came and were desperate, they left in exactly the same desperate state they came in.
Well, I don't understand what you're saying.
Surrounding yourself with bodyguards and driving a big yellow Hummer, it's all part of the deception. It's all part of the thing that blinds people and that convinces people that you are special. That's why they run after you. That's why they want to touch you. That's why they throw money at your feet.
Well, in the Bible, for material blessings, the Bible teaches for you to sow in order for you to have a harvest. It's a fundamental principle of the doctrine of the Word of God.
Like many other Nigerian pastors, Dr. Fireman's obsession with wealth is a key part of his religion. It defines his existence and sense of self-worth. It's what he promotes to others, and he seems to genuinely believe that it's the way to spiritual enlightenment. Prosperity has always been the holy grail of Nigerian society. Now it seems running your own church has become just another way to achieve the Nigerian dream.